Hi everybody, this is Robbie from Southern California, and I'm going to share a story with you that is an absolute true story, and it's hard to believe, but it really did happen on hummingbirds. Now keep in mind, I started feeding hummingbirds just over 5 years ago, and there weren't that many around. We were so happy to see a couple, and then of course the numbers built up into the thousands, but that's not what the story's about. The story's about 4 years ago, I had a hummingbird feeder right out my kitchen window. I had actually cut a hole in the screen. I put a hook that swings so I could swing the hummingbird feeder in the house just above my sink. I could change the feeder and swing it back out and drop my screen down. Well, everything was fine and the hummingbirds found it and they were feeding off of it. And it was such a joy to stand by the sink to be able to do dishes and watch the hummingbirds feed from morning till night. Well, one day this little hummingbird came and she was sitting on top of the hook. I had no idea what she was doing. It was very odd. She was sitting there and she was poking at it and poking at it. And I thought, well, maybe she likes it as a perch. I mean, what else could she do with a long hook? All of a sudden, she started sticking things to it. Yes, sticking things to it. I still couldn't believe what she was doing. She started it in the morning and she kept doing it. And then after a couple hours, I saw what I couldn't believe could possibly be. It looked like she was building a nest on the very hummingbird feeder that she feeds off of daily. She decided to build a nest on top of the hook, knowing she knows that the hook is swung in the house and swung back outside every day, but she continued to build. Within 2 days, she had the nest completely done. Now I was thinking, what in the world am I going to do? So as the feeder ran empty, I waited and she started to buzz around the feeder and buzz around the feeder like the feeder is empty almost. They can tell when it's almost empty. So I swung it in, I did my thing, took it off, washed it, put it back up, and she went right back to her nest and she kept all the other hummingbirds away from that feeder. That one feeder became her feeder. Well, obviously she didn't mind me changing the feeder out and putting in new food when needed. And I would do it every 2 to 3 days. And if it was still with some food in it, I would take it in, scrub it out, clean it like I usually do. I like using baking soda and water and cleaning up real good and put it back out. Didn't bother her at all. She just got off the nest. She could wait in the tree. She can wait in the hibiscus flowers, whatever she wants to do. And then she'd come right back. Sometimes she'd even buzz around waiting for me. Well, she laid 2 eggs in there and soon had 2 babies. I continued to do my everyday routine, whatever needed to be done. If the feeder was empty or near empty, I never filled it to the top. If it was just hers, just a small amount of food, I would bring it in, do the whole thing. And we went through that. But here's the funny thing. Not only did I go through that the one time, I went through the same routine for 2 years, 6 times. 6 times. She had 3 nests that year. And the following year, she came back, rebuilt the nest, and had another 3 nests. I then put another hummingbird feeder on the other window, and now I've got more than a half a dozen there. But I put another one there. She kept her feeder to herself. That was her feeder where she had her nest, and the other feeders on the other window belonged to other birds. So nobody bothered her. Nobody bothered her at all. There was one time, we'll get into that in a minute. So once the babies were big enough, I stopped the swinging. Unless they were totally not looking, I didn't bring it in. She started to feed off the other feeder and it was not changed as regularly. I was just nervous on the babies, but not her at all. 2 years in a row. On the 3rd year, she came back, recognized her, and she took it apart, dismantled the nest, and built it on the other side of the house, but not there. She has not built another nest on that particular hook, but she has, or some of the other hummingbirds have, built nests around the house on other hummingbird hooks, on cable wires, on Christmas light wires, all over the place. We have nests everywhere. The only other thing I was going to say, at one time during one of her clutches, she got egg bound. I wasn't sure exactly at first what it was, but then I recognized that she was egg bound. She sat all day on top of the hook laboring, and a couple times some orioles came by because she wasn't fighting anybody off. This was the 1st year. I believe it was the 3rd nest. And I stood home all day by that window. I am home most of the time anyways, but I stood by that window all day and chased all the birds away from her. She knew it. She absolutely knew it. I thought we were going to lose her, but we didn't. By the end of the day, she went back in the nest after she labored, her breathing labored and everything. She sat there and by morning, she had that 2nd egg and all was good. And she raised those 2 babies. The story sounds unbelievable. I know that because I can't believe. She was literally every day for 2 years in my face. My sink in the kitchen is right there. You look out at her. The window's open all day. She's about 2 feet from my face. And basically, I guess I was her entertainment. She raised the babies there in a very unique way because she would take the babies out when they started to fly. She would bring them sometimes to the hibiscus plant. She'd have them fly around, and many times she brought the babies back to roost at night in the nest until they were completely on their own. When the first set of babies left the nest, they stayed in the area in the hibiscus plants or the orange trees that we have out the window, and she raised the second nest. And as long as they were her siblings, they were allowed to feed out that feeder. I would put the feeder back as soon as the babies left. She would continue to use that feeder, and then she would allow her babies to use the feeder, but no other birds could use that feeder. So by the end of the season, we had 7 birds feeding out of that one feeder until the babies were completely fledged. And once they were completely on their own and she was done with the third clutch, she then went off to do what she does, and she became basically like a normal bird. So it is a true story. I hope one day that her or one of her siblings builds another nest there. It would be so much fun. And at that time, I was doing very little YouTube, so I didn't get a lot of footage. Oh, how I wish I did. But everything you're seeing here is from her nest that she did on my kitchen window that I did manage to take some footage with the simple camera I had, and we enjoyed her company all that time. And all I have to say is I am so grateful that I can put that 1/4 cup of white granulated sugar mixed with 1 cup of water out every single day for these birds, and I never let the feeders run completely dry. I take them in and scrub them. The birds know it, and I am grateful that they come here, live here in our gardens, because they bring us such joy, and I am happy I can help them with the severe drought that we are dealing with here in Southern California. So I hope you enjoyed this story. It is a true story. And if you've got hummingbirds, put that little feeder out. Change it every 3 days if it still has food in it. And believe you me, they'll find it eventually, and you will be graced with their pleasure as well. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. And as I say for our gardening channel, don't forget to eat what you grow. Bye-bye.